Okay, today we're working on a condensate pump. It's overflowing and we got a safety switch on there. Right here. And she's been keeping it clean. It's really clean inside. It's just the pump had failed. It's not pumping. So we are going to replace it with this. And we'll get the safety switch all put back on there. But this is just a quick condensate pump replacement. Let me get you on the tripod. Okay, let me see if I can. So I got my furnace is off. That's dead. So I'm gonna cut my safety switch. So we're gonna wire nut that switch into the other one. This thing's full of water, and I do not know if there's water in there. Try to. Sometimes I gotta cut them off. Wow. Man, that hose is on there. Now, get this pump off. And there we go. Houston, we got a problem. Make sure you take your tab out. If you look and see, I don't have anything over here. So I'm going to have to reverse this like so. And I'll have to bring this hose over here. Not a big deal. It's level. go. Push it on, give it some support. Oh wow, that's tight. There we go. Safety switch goes right there. Looks like I got enough slack. Connections. Connections back there. Childproof. Holy crap. There we go. And what we'll do is I'll get my container and we'll water test this thing. Maybe I'll just turn the furnace on. Now I'll get a container and water test it. I'll be right back. Okay, now I'm going to water test this. In my little port here. I'll probably have to get two of these. that was 32 ounces. It takes about another half. And there it goes. No leaks present. No leaks. And it's working. You always want to water test them. Because if you don't, if you got a little leak around here, it'll turn, you can call back. You want to call back. But the way the safety switch wires in, actually, this goes to the control board. R comes out, 24 volts comes out through the pump and back to the actual thermostat R wire. So then all the power has to go through here. So if this condensate pump fails, either air conditioning or heating, it stops the whole system because we're producing water. Heating and air conditioning, also the humidifier too. So we want to completely shut the system down if we run into condensate overflow, because we don't know what it's from, but at least I'm stopping any damage from happening. So that's it for this one. Like and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. And go from there.